In this video, I want to take a look, a little bit of a closer look, at Levine's test of equality of variances. And in fact, what exactly is Levine's test doing when we do test for equal variances? And recall that Levine's test is a test to see whether the variances for two or more groups are equal. Levine's test comes up in the independent samples t-test and in the one-way ANOVA as an assumption of both of those procedures. And it also comes up in other procedures as well. But most people would be familiar with it in these two tests. And what it's testing there is whether the population variances for the two groups if you're doing an independent t-test, or for three or more groups for an ANOVA, whether those variances are equal in the population. And the reason why Levine's test is used in the t-test and the ANOVA is because it is an assumption of both of those tests. So when we run those procedures, we want to make sure that the assumption appears to be satisfied, or if it's not satisfied, then we want to do what's necessary to make sure that the test performs well. But in this video, I don't want to spend time so much on what to do if Levine's test is violated, but rather to dive in and see what is it exactly that Levine's test is doing. First of all, how do we assess it? And then see if we can figure out what Levine's test really is a measure of. So in this example here you see on your screen, we have two variables. We have volume, our independent variable, and then exam scores, our dependent variable. And there were 20 people in the study, with 10 people in the no volume group, which we have labeled a 1, and then 10 people are in the high volume group, which is labeled a 2. And then we have exam scores. I could run an independent samples t-test, and let's go ahead and do that and take a look and see what Levine's test would look like there. So if I go to Analyze, Compare Means, and then Independent Samples t-test, and then move our exam scores, our dependent variable, into the test variables box, volume will go into the grouping variable box, and we'll enter ones and twos since that's what no volume and high volume correspond to. So click on Define Groups. Group 1 gets a 1. Group 2 gets a 2, and then click Continue, and then OK. And here we get the results, and just zeroing in to the Levine's test, you can see here that Levine's test for equality of variances is shown, and notice we have an F value. Levine's test is an ANOVA, and we have an F of 0.078 with a p-value of 0.783. Now just as a quick review here for Levine's test, typically, if you use an alpha of 0.05, which is the most common value to use, you want to compare the p-value to 0.05. And if the p-value reported as sig in SPSS is less than or equal to 0.05, then we want to reject the null. It means the test is significant. And this provides some evidence that the variances may be unequal in the population. If p is greater than 0.05, this gives us some evidence that the variances are equal in the population. So in terms of trying to satisfy the assumption of equal variances, we want this value to be greater than 0.05, and it is, so that looks good. I'll go ahead and close this out. And then you also can access this assumption through the ANOVA procedure. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at that. If we go to Analyze and then Compare Means and then One-Way ANOVA, and then here we want to move exam scores to our dependent list, and then volume to factor, which is another name for independent variable. And then click on Options. And then under Statistics, we want to go ahead and select Homogeneity of Variance Test. Click Continue, and then OK. And then notice in the one-way ANOVA, we get a separate table for Test of Homogeneity of Variances. And it says Levene Statistic, 0.078. with a p-value of 0.783. And it also reports the degrees of freedom, as you can see there. Now, if you compare this Levene statistic, 0.078, that's the same thing we have for independent samples test under here, 0.078, as you can see there, for Levene's test. And the p-values also match, 0.783 for sig, 0.783 for sig. So this test can be accessed either way, either through the independent samples t-test, it comes out by default here, we don't even have to ask for it, or through the one-way ANOVA where we ask for it and it comes out as a separate table. Okay, next, let's go ahead and take a look and see if we can figure out what Levine's test is actually testing. Recall that it's trying to test whether the variances are equal. So it's testing some type of variability, some measure of variability in our data. But let's go ahead and go to our data editor window and take a look at that and see if we can figure this out here, or see if we can demonstrate how Levine's test is calculated. Now what it does is, basically, Levine's test determines how far away each value in a given group, such as the no volume, how far away each value is from its own group mean. So in other words, we're going to subtract the mean of these values from each score here, and then we're going to find a mean of these values and subtract that mean from each score here. So the first thing we need to do is find the mean. And to do that, we can go to Data, and then Aggregate. And this is actually a very interesting procedure here, which can come in quite handy.